As we spoke before the break, Governor Walz said that the state departments of health and education will be working with local districts to decide if distance or in-school learning or a hybrid of both would be best for students. Decisions that will be based on the level of virus activity in individual counties and districts. Minnesota Department of Education Commissioner Mary Cathryn Ricker was in that news conference this afternoon, and there were plenty of questions being asked after the announcement, Commissioner. If social media is any gauge, overall, we have been seeing a lot of positive reactions to this announcement today.
Thank you for sharing that. You know, we took this charge very seriously. As I said in the press conference, this may be the most ambitious group project any of us have ever been a part of.
And it wasn't anything that you all could have known a year ago that you would be facing.
That's right. And, you know, we have learned to expect the unexpected. And, you know, we stayed grounded in the same goals the entire time we've been working through this. The safety and health of our school communities, our students, our staff, their families, as well as that desire to bring students back to school physically wherever and whenever it is safely possible to do so.
Okay, with that said, that leads me to this question. The virus has divided people and become a very political issue, unfortunately, Commissioner. In-school learning caters more to conservatives is what we keep seeing, and distance learning more so to liberals. By giving parents the ultimate option of allowing to have their kid in school, or if they think maybe it is just better to keep them at home, is there any concern that our schools will be divided politically?
This is also one of the reasons that we wanted to make sure that our plan was localized, driven by data, and grounded in the science. Because it is really disappointing that a decision as important as the safe and healthy learning conditions of our students and working conditions of our educators has become something that some people see as partisan. We see it as a decision about safety grounded in teaching and learning.
Good.
And so we wanted to make sure we had that localized approach. We use the data we have available to us, and we ground our decisions in the science of what helps us fight this virus, quite frankly, and make our whole communities healthy.
I am so glad that you said that, because when we look and we see the bickering, whether we're getting emails or if it's on social media, how political people make this. But let me ask you this, much like the mask issue, mayors wanted a mandate from the state so then they didn't have to do it on the local level because of the politics of all of this. Now, this could be the same with our schools. So leaving it up to individual districts, our superintendents might face some of that pressure, and it might be very, very difficult for them.
We have made it clear, and I have made it clear as Commissioner of Education, that no school district or charter school will be making this decision alone. We have the resources at the Minnesota Department of Health, the resources and the support from all of my colleagues at the entire Department of Education, as well as those local public health experts that our school leaders likely already know and are going to work alongside, not just to make this first decision about how they begin the school year, but we are with them for the long haul, for every decision it takes to meet the needs of students during this entire school year, and as long as this pandemic is with us, and then beyond, as we, of course, support our students to recover from this situation, and as we rebuild our school communities for that full, robust in-person experience.
I think there are some superintendents that are going to be happy to hear you reiterate that, because they're worried that the anger will be on them. So what about teachers who would rather not be in the classroom for their own safety, as many of them, 49% in the most recent poll, had said they want distance learning? So what about those teachers who do not want to be in the classroom? What is going to be their responsibility?
Well, so one of the things we have to understand too is that every data point matters in this equation to determine how we can safely open a school building. In some cases, if there is an educator or a school staff person who has a compromised medical situation, or perhaps they live with a family member who has a compromised medical situation. We want to accommodate that individual staff member to the extent possible. And at the same time, if we are seeing large numbers, as our school leaders are surveying their school staff, as well as their families and their students, and if they are seeing large numbers of people concerned about coming back to school, that's also a data point to ask more questions. What is it about that that concerns you? What are the sort of conditions that would, where you would have confidence returning to school?
You have a job that I do not envy, that is for sure. Thank there are so many decisions that y'all have to make, and we're still navigating things. I really appreciate your time and answering some of my questions.
Absolutely.